We're in that weather alert. Given the heat and humidity on tap for tomorrow, a heat advisory up for most of the state that runs until 8 p.m. Meanwhile, we're also tracking the tropics. No depressions, no named storms right now, and nothing heading in the direction of New England. However, things are pretty active. We've got one area of low pressure, a wave off the coast of Africa, one to the southeast of Bermuda. The one that bears closest watching right now is around Jamaica, and it's heading toward the Yucatan Peninsula, and it is this one over the upcoming weekend. That could become our next tropical storm and could have implications for the U.S. Gulf Coast from Texas into Louisiana, something, again, they'll have to monitor closely. So the next name on the list would be Ida, followed by Julian, Kate, and you can see the list going down thereafter. So, of course, keep you updated as we move forward in time here in Connecticut. The big weather headline, of course, the heat and the humidity. With regard to our 90-degree tally, we hit it again today. So for the month, up to 6 days for the year 22. And interesting to point out, compared to this time last year, last year on August 25th, we hit our last 90-degree day, and it was a record-setting one because it was our 39th for 2020. So we're going to be adding to our tally as we head into tomorrow and likely into Friday with more 90-degree heat here as we head through the rest of the week. So currently here in the 11 o'clock hour, temperatures in the low and mid-70s inland. The warm spot on the map, Bridgeport, 80 degrees at 11 o'clock at night. So pretty warm throughout southwestern Connecticut. Dew point values up close to 70. So yes, it is quite humid, and that is making it feel even warmer. So that is going to be the case, especially tomorrow afternoon with the peak of the heating. Right now, you can see the waning full sturgeon moon from Waterbury looking live there. 72 degrees in the Brass City and looking live from New London as well. Mainly clear right now. If anything, some scattered high clouds. High pressure is offshore, so clockwise flow around that high is going to keep the southwesterly flow going tomorrow, and why temps for our Thursday will be a couple degrees warmer than today, and also why it will be muggier tomorrow than what we experienced this afternoon across Connecticut. So currently, temps again in the 70s. They're not going to be dropping much of the overnight hours, bottoming out close to the 70-degree mark. And as we make our way through our Thursday, any morning patchy fog should give way to clearing sunshine through the first half of the day. And during the afternoon tomorrow, a chance for an isolated shower to pop up, but a situation where many communities remain dry, with otherwise a partly to mostly sunny sky. High temperatures for our Thursday afternoon, a degree or two warmer than earlier today, 90 to 95 inland, and from the mid-80s coastal southeast Connecticut to low 90s working farther west along the shoreline. So heat index values, say for instance, 8 o'clock in the morning, low and mid-80s in spots, and as we make our way into the afternoon, 95 to 100 degrees. So again, if you're outside, take frequent breaks. Stay hydrated with water, and if you can, spend time indoors and near air conditioning. So in our early warning 7-day forecast on Friday, there's perhaps a slightly better chance for a shower or storm. Still humid, temperatures at least in the low 90s, so that's when our heat wave becomes official. And then a cold front moves through Friday night and stalls near southern New England. We're going to be on the cooler side of it. Waves of low pressure right along that. We've got an onshore flow. It's going to mean a lot of cloud cover for Saturday. On and off showers. When it's not showering, there's going to be the potential for some drizzle. So temps will be dramatically cooler by 15 degrees compared to Friday. Then for Sunday, we could see some breaks in the clouds. If that happens with enough sunshine, we could reach 80 or better. Then there's a chance for some late day showers Sunday. Monday, low 80s, humid, chance for some late day storms with the cold front, 86 Tuesday. And then by Wednesday of next week, looking at the chance for some showers and storms, highs then only in the 70s. For shoreline highs, 70s for both Saturday and Sunday.
Ark, thank you very much. Well, channel